as he is often, as our listeners and viewers know. But he is in a special place in Irvine, California, where he was attending a special event put on by this man. You've seen him before if you're a longtime listener or watcher of the show. It's always great to have him on. He's super fun. He's smart as a whip, actually, but he's hilarious. Guest host, the CIO for IT Innovators and CEO for the SMB TechFest and Pro Tier Peer Groups. I believe I got all that right. Dave Seibert.
Awesome. Thanks, Matt. I love the intro. I'll try to be all of that. No pressure, right?
You don't even have to try, Dave. You're just that awesome. So lots of folks have known. Dave has been a guest host a bunch of times, sometimes filling in for Rich when he's not around. So it's always a treat to have you on to discuss things. And of course, you are also a CIO. You're totally entrenched in this business. You work with customers. You know this stuff.
Yes to all the above, or at least I try.
So for those who might be new, do you want to give everybody a quick, just, 1 minute paragraph overview of who you are and what you do?
Yeah, absolutely. And the nighttime bedtime reading is daveseibert.com. So, but the quick answer is I'm entrenched in our market, our industry. This is my passion. This is what I love to do. So, IT Innovators is an MSP in Southern California of about 24 years. I also do a quarterly technology conference for solution providers, MSPs, and all the other fun acronyms in our industry, which is SMBTechFest.com. And hopefully we'll probably chat. We just had a show yesterday. And Matt, as you mentioned, I also run peer groups for partners for many years, which is ProTierPeerGroups.com. So I wear a few hats in life, do a few other things. Love doing it. Wouldn't have it any other way.
And not only do you wear multiple hats, at most shows I see, you also wear two badges. So it's always good to know and to have a backup with your name on it in case you get that drunk.
You know, it wouldn't be so funny, but I was at CES about 2 weeks ago. And what they have, 180,000 people. Anyway, I had two badges there also. And everybody's like, hey, you're the only person I've seen with two badges. So now my moniker, my thing is, you're the guy with two badges. People remember me that way. How funny.
It is a memorable thing because you don't see it all that often. So now, Rich, you are in a hotel room in Irvine because you are at Dave Seibert's SMB Tech Fest show. How did that go?
It went great. It went great. And in fact, it's a sort of a fixture on my calendar every year that in January, I'm going to make my way down to Southern California to attend the first SMB Tech Fest of the year. And this is the quarterly show. Dave does these four times a year here now in the Irvine area. This is actually the second time Dave has done this show at a new venue he's using, which is fabulous. A great setting for the event, but also a great event. He had, and you'll correct me if I get that mispronounced name, but it was Brent Watkins, right?
Yes.
Former retired FBI agent, now a consultant in the cybersecurity world. Very interesting speaker. Larry Walsh from 2112 Group, one of the smartest observers of the managed services and ChannelPro landscape there is out there. He came out and gave a talk yesterday, which I absolutely adored. It was hilarious. Larry gets up on stage, and the first thing he does is apologize, because I'm going to throw a lot of numbers at you folks, and nobody likes numbers. And I'm thinking, I love numbers. And so it was just a real, Dave too. It's just a really, really interesting talk based on some research that he's done recently. And then Dave also did on stage a Q&A with the CTO of, Microsoft US, their CTO?
Microsoft US CTO, David Totten. And he was awesome. I mean, he's been at Microsoft 15 years, and his insights in technology. We talked platforms, we talked new technology trends, where are things going, what do partners need to know. It was a fun one-on-one.
And it was actually a really great, the timing was great to have him at an event like this, because as we all know, there is nothing that matters more to Microsoft right now than Azure consumption. And so they are looking for anyone and everyone to develop applications, host them on Azure, and drive Azure consumption. And that, you know, first and foremost, that means professional developers, ISVs and so on. But they're very much encouraging all kinds of partners to convert that intellectual property you created for a customer into a product and put that on Azure as well. So, I mean, you know, there's an opportunity for anyone in the Microsoft channel to get in on that kind of product development. And Totten's team spends a lot of its time working with partners who are developing applications on the Microsoft platform and to some extent talking to end users using those applications as well. So it was actually kind of an interesting time for him to be at a show like this. And I will say this too, Matt, you mentioned rightly the many of the many fine things about Dave Seibert. The other thing I'll toss in there is he's actually a pretty good interviewer. Speaking as a professional interviewer, you know what? When he gets up on stage with somebody like that, he does a good job of guiding the conversation.
Absolutely agreed. Agreed.
Yeah, you know, I'll have to squeeze in really quick that David also talked about Power Apps and Power BI. And definitely the direction things are continuing to go. And then just lastly, oh my gosh, he has like a team of near 300. So if you haven't learned about him, he's awesome. Good reading stuff.
Let me do this quickly, Dave, because I got back from the show last night and it occurred to me, you know, every year, particularly when I go to your Q1 show, I usually try to pull you aside and do an interview and just get some thoughts from you about, you know, what you're thinking about the agenda this year, what's your plan for this year's events, how are they different, why are they valuable? Totally just forgot to do it yesterday. And I thought, well, conveniently, I'm going to have Dave on the podcast the next morning. So let's do a little live journalism here and make up for the interview that I should have done yesterday. Just give me and the folks in our audience a quick sense for what, you know, as you pulled this year's series of events together, what was on your mind? What were the themes? What kinds of things you're looking to accomplish this year?
Yeah, no, I appreciate that. You know, the first thing is that this is a conference that pulls together technologists in our industry. So the MSPs, the ISVs, the VARs, the systems integrators, solutions in our industry, and then of course what I love to refer to as the hallway conversations. Every event that I go to, so many people always talk about the hallway conversation and how they got so much out of talking to each other, and I bring that hallway conversation into the live event because that's what drives a lot of value. And when I think about what goes into the show, I'm always looking at what's hot, what's happening in the marketplace. You know, obviously security. It was a couple of years ago, everybody talked about backup. And backup is still important, but backup has almost taken a second seat to security. And only a second seat in conversation, not in need. But so there's definitely a lot of focus. That's why I had the FBI cybersecurity retired at the show. That's why David Microsoft was at the show. And also, we didn't mention Kendra Lee. And Kendra Lee is all about sales and marketing for the MSP solution provider. So I think this is January. Let's redefine focus. Let's think about how we're going to go to market. Let's think about what security solutions are out there that may not be part of our offering, but should be part of our offering. How do you price it? Where's the margins? How do you get your clientele to buy in on what you are proposing that they really need to do? All of those thoughts kind of go together when I'm laying out the show. And I'll give a compliment to all the other shows in the industry, yours included, and ChannelPro Forum Live. And when I go to these shows, boy, I pick out the gold nuggets of the things as a solution provider myself that help my business, and I take all those nuggets and drop them into the show or find a way to drop them into the show. And that's really the thought process that happens, that goes. So network, talk business, talk technology, and help everybody drive things forward into 2020.
Now, I know you like to kind of mix it up a little bit. speakers and so on. So just kind of looking ahead to the April, the Q2 event, do you have a different special guest speaker, anything like that you can talk about?
So the thing to know is it's not a roadshow. And what I mean by that is that a roadshow traditionally, you know, Holiday on Ice, if you remember those, you know, you had the same cast of characters in a good way, and they go across the country and they present the same topic because you're traveling across country. In my case, I consider home base Southern California. That's where the shows are done by design. And as a result of that, you know, when people come in and come and attend the show, I do not repeat topics. So I may have a speaker that may be at the show twice in the year, but they're going to talk about something original, something unique. So no repeat topics, I think, is the first thing to know. And then as far as the theme, it's creative and spontaneous in that I plan the next quarter as soon as the first quarter ends. So I'm literally planning quarter by quarter. And that's by design too, because our industry changes so quickly, so fast. I mean, you guys, ChannelPro, I get your daily news briefings and your journalism, you're on the game. But my point is that news happens that fast. And therefore, I by design plan the shows each quarter, because each quarter there's something that's happening in our industry that makes it relevant for everybody to attend. And that's what keeps it fresh and exciting. And I'll make a little teaser announcement since you kind of brought up Q2. So our diamond sponsor for Q2 is Google. And so Google will be at the show. This will be, they were at the show last year. And they'll be at the show again this year, Q2. So I'm excited to kind of make that announcement with you guys and the audience.
No doubt you'll be talking about a lot of numbers, because I know you really like numbers. I'm okay with numbers. Like, I really like number 3, but the rest of the numbers are just all kind of overrated.
I happen to like the number 5. We'll get into that when we talk in the bar and have some fun.
3 versus 5, yeah.
But, you know, I got to tell you, speaking of numbers, I know it can get boring and you jump into the weeds, but businesses are driven by KPIs. And when you have a handle on your KPIs, your business takes off like a rocket ship. And if you don't have a handle on your numbers and you don't know your KPIs, you're just kind of suffering and you don't know why and you don't know what to do about it. And you're just throwing stuff against the wall. So we tease about numbers, but they really do help our market move forward.
That they do. Well, awesome. So your next show is in April, Southern California.
It is.
Go to smbtechfest.com, right?
smbtechfest.com, and you can do /events, April 15, 16.
Awesome. So go there. We'll put a link to that on our show sheet so people can find that after the show. So go and check that out.
And nobody likes a slacker, so make sure you're there.
Right. And we, ChannelPro, are very anti-slacker. I agree.